Let us consider some more examples. Other examples for leaching processes. During the metallurgy of silver and gold, argentinum and iron, the respective metals are leached with a dilute solution of sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide. That means, for the isolation of silver and iron from the earth crust, these metals are leached. The metals are leached by using aqueous solution of sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide in the presence of air. So when these silver and gold metals are interacted with aqueous solution of either sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide in the presence of air, they are going to form a complex cyanide system. So the formed cyanide complex further reacted with zinc to isolate our pure either silver or gold metal. So let us write the chemical reactions included in this process. First, metal in solid form. What is metal here? Iron and argentinum, that is silver and gold, present in earth crust are going to react with either sodium cyanide or potassium cyanide, and also in the presence of oxygen. So when the reaction condition is like this, now the metal by reacting with cyanides, it is going to produce MCN taken twice minus. So it is going to form a cyanide complex by reacting with metals like silver and gold. Now the formed metal complex MCN taken twice minus, when it reacted with zinc to produce our pure metal, plus it is going to form a complex called zinc cyanide, tetracyanozinc, or tetracyanozincate 2 is the resulting compound. That means the impurities which may be present with silver and gold will be eliminated by using this leaching process. So this is the most important process. It is called as leaching process. The specified conditions are required to use leaching process, that is, in case of ore only soluble in solvent, gangue is not soluble in solvent, in such cases only we have to use leaching process for the purification of ore. And after this, after the process of concentration of ore, what is the next important step included in isolation or extraction of metal from ore is isolation of or extraction of metal from concentrated ore. The second step included is extraction of crude metal from concentrated ore. Extraction of pure metal from concentrated ore. So in the first and very beginning step, first we have to eliminate gangue present in the ore. That process is called as concentration of ore or dressing of ore or benefaction of ore. Here, after completion of this step, and second method or second step in the extraction of metal is extraction of crude metal from concentrated ore. What is the third step? After the extraction of crude metal may be with some impurities. In the third step, the crude metal, by using some electroplating processes, we can convert crude metal into metal into pure metal. So let us have, during the extraction of crude metal from concentrated ore, in the very beginning step, we have to convert, other forms of ore into oxides of those metals. So we can write, we have to convert other forms of ore or other forms of metals into oxides of those metals. The very beginning step for the extraction of crude metal from the concentrated ore, we have to convert other forms of metals into those of oxide forms, because in the extraction process, the most widely used step is reduction. By using reducing process, we can extract crude metal from concentrated ore. For that reason only, oxides can easily undergoes reduction. Hence, this is the reason why we have to convert other forms of metals into oxide forms. Those oxides can easily undergoes reduction process to produce our crude metal. Example, if sulfide ores are present, they are converted into oxide ores. The sulfide forms of metals converted into oxide forms. So let us have the two steps included for the extraction of crude from the concentrated ore. The first one is, as I told you, conversion of other oxides or conversion of ore into metal oxide. This is possible if the ore is in another form, not in oxide form. If it is present in another form, like sulfide form or carbonate form or whatever the form, carbide form. So such ores are converted into their metal oxides. Second one, reduction of oxides to produce metal. The reduction takes place onto the metal oxides, and now during the reduction, the metal oxides can produce pure metals. So let us one, the first step, conversion of ore into their oxides. Conversion of ore into oxides. So during this process, the most important one is, for the conversion of other forms of ore into their metal oxide forms, we have to use calcination process. So in this calcination process, all other forms of ores are reacted with or heated up to their or below their fusion point.